Everybody, today I'm going to be sharing with you a little topic. It's called Garbage In, Garbage Out. This is a science curriculum. And what really interests me in this topic is the name given, Garbage In, Garbage Out. It sounds very exciting. This is chapter 16. We're just going to go ahead and read until 16.1. Let's go. We throw out so much rubbish or garbage every day from our homes or anywhere we are, no matter what place we are in, even when we are overseas. Anything which is not of use is always ending up in the dustbin. The grains, pulses, biscuits, milk, anything which you purchase in the shop, even like, no, it's true, because whenever you go to the shop and you buy like a bag of broccoli, then it comes in a plastic bag. Then once you get home, you remove the broccoli and you throw the plastic bag away. Similarly, if you get like a canned noodle soup, and once you finish the noodles, you throw the can away. So basically anything which is not of use anymore is always ending up in the garbage. We generate so much garbage in our day-to-day activities. Like, some examples given are when, you know, those peanuts, right? They come in shells. When you eat the peanut, you throw the shell away. Sometimes you throw them in buses or trains or even on the road sometimes. And once you're done using a particular ticket, suppose you're going to a fair, you're done using the ticket, and then you're like, oh, I don't need this anymore, and you put it in the dustbin. And have you ever seen, like, many children just, like, going on and sharpening pencils just for fun? That's also like a waste, because the pencil, it's a waste of pencil, and also it's generating a lot of garbage. And mostly, have you ever like made a mistake on a paper and you like, it's a pen, you used a pen and you cannot really erase it, so now you have to tear the paper and throw it away. It's a lot of waste. And we also throw away many domestic waste. Like, if you have a broken slipper, you throw it away. If you have an old toy, you throw it away. Old clothes, you throw it away. It goes for anything which is not of use anymore. But what if the garbage is not removed from our homes and surroundings? Like, yeah, you might be thinking that, oh no, if I don't remove it, my house is gonna stink. Ew, I have to remove garbage now. But another thing in this topic which we will be covering is, how do you think this will harm us? Like, just like I said, you'll say, oh my god, my house is gonna stink. When Safai Karamcharis, I think it's that means like a garbage truck where they come and collect the garbage. Yeah, that's what it's called. Take the garbage from the bins. Where does it go? I think most of you have been wondering, where does the garbage go? What happens to it? Does it get reused again? Yeah, I'm wondering that too. Is it possible for all of this garbage to be changed into something that will not harm us? Actually, have you ever heard of compost? I'm pretty sure you have. Most people, they like take the old leftovers of banana peels, sometimes it's eggshells, onion peels, and they just put it for plants, so that's not harmful to us. Can we contribute to this in any way? Yes, we will look for answers to these questions in this chapter. So there are two people, Pahali and Buju. Their school did a project called Dealing with Garbage. I wonder what that's about. We will learn about some of the things they learned through this project. Okay, we will continue with 16.1 tomorrow. This was just a brief overview. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell notifications. And as always, comment down below for future video ideas and any other things you want me to review. Bye!